Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Sarah and today's video is going to be a Project Pan update. This is an update for my Mission 100% Cruelty Free Project Pan, and this Project Pan is aimed at getting my collection to be 100% cruelty free. If you're not new to my channel, you probably have noticed that I haven't been updating my project pans. I have talked about this also in my whole collection project pan, which I believe will be going up before this update. Basically, ended up sort of on accident taking a little bit of a break from project panning, and I have been focusing a lot more on trying out new products and trying out new techniques, and I've really been enjoying that. I've really found like my passion for makeup again. The other thing about this project is that I have been decluttering a lot of my makeup, and if you haven't seen my declutter series, I will try to put together a playlist and leave it linked down below, but if I don't have a playlist, I will leave just some of the videos linked for you. But I've been doing declutters because I do want to get rid of some things that I just am not excited about, that I don't enjoy using, get rid of expired makeup that I have sort of just been leaving in my drawers and pretending that they're fine and oh, I'll pan them someday. One of the things though was I wanted to declutter a lot of my non-cruelty-free makeup because I want to have more room to use products that I'm going to be able to talk about and recommend on my channel. So while I did keep some non-cruelty-free stuff, I also decluttered 4 of the 5 products that were in this video, or I will be decluttering some of them. So I have already decluttered 2, and I have 2 that I will show you kind of where I'm leaving off on them, but they will be getting decluttered. This is a collab project. I'm so sorry, I should have mentioned that sooner. I'm rambly. There is a playlist, I will leave it linked down below, and oh my goodness, please, 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 you guys, please yell at me if I'm not putting your video in the playlist. It is not my intention to leave people out. Please, please let me know if you've been uploading videos about this project pan and I'm not putting your videos in the playlist, please let me know. It's not my intention to leave people out of a collab that they want to join. Like, that's not at all my intention. Okay, so the 2 products that I have taken out of this project because I already decluttered them, it's the Laura Mercier Loose Translucent Powder. It's the one that I had in a very, like, small little sample size. And then I also have decluttered my Makeup Forever Ultra HD Foundation Stick. If you want to know more about why I decluttered those, I will leave my declutter videos linked down below for you. So then that leaves me with 3 products left in this project pan, and I do have the next 2 that I'm also decluttering, but I have them here with me, and I'm just going to kind of give them their own little farewell. So the first one is the MAC Golden Rinse Studio Sculpt Defining Bronzing Powder. This is what it's looking like. Hopefully you can see on camera, but I did hit pan on this. It's kind of a weird little pan. It's almost like the product kind of collapsed in on itself. And I also hope you'll be able to see, at least in the picture, how much hard pan is on this. This product is just extremely, extremely old. I bought this such a long time ago, and I really, you know, did have every intention of finishing it, but it honestly doesn't look good on me. It's a little too dark, and because it's an older bronzer, it doesn't blend out well. I just don't want to spend time panning this when I have other bronzers that I absolutely love. And on top of that, my makeup was looking not great, in my opinion. So I have to declutter this. I haven't done my bronzer declutter yet, so I am going to hold on to this until that video, but I will be decluttering it. And then next up, I have my Nars Orgasm Blush. This is a very well-known blush, very iconic. It's a cult favorite. I did hit pan on this in a couple updates ago, I think, and I expanded the pan like a little bit, but again, I have so many other blushes that I absolutely love. This is not performing the same. It's just so old. There's so much hard pan. It doesn't blend very well. It doesn't last. It's gotta go. It's expired for sure. Yeah, I could suffer my way through it and pan it, but then my other blushes are just going to also get old and get hard pan on them and not perform very well. So I am choosing to declutter this now before I devote any more time to it. I would rather pan some other blushes. I would rather rotate through my collection and get more use out of things. I'm really glad that I did hit pan on it. It feels good to be able to throw both of these products away, having pan on them at the very least. I just felt like between the two of these products, my makeup has just been not looking the way that I want it to because they're not products that are performing well. And if it's a product that's not performing well because it's expired, like, I need to not try and pan those things. To me, it just doesn't make sense. I can understand why other people might choose to kind of challenge themselves and work their way through products like these, but that's just not what I want to do. So we're going to go ahead and say goodbye to these guys. And you know what? They were loved. They had some good days, and that's good enough for me. So saying goodbye to these, but I'm doing it with a very happy heart, okay? I feel good about it. So the one product that is staying in my project pan is the MAC Fix It Plus Goldlite. I just used this. It's all kind of like bubbly and shooken up and everything, so I'm gonna wait to make a mark on it, but I don't think the mark is going to be like, it's going to be very close to the one before it because I have not used this very much. I think I've only used this 3 times since my last update, and it's been a very long time since my last update. And like I mentioned, I've just been trying out other things. I just haven't been devoted to my project panning items, and that's okay with me. I really need to drop the mentality of like worrying that people are going to be disappointed in me for not meeting my panning goals. Because when my friends think that way, I'm like, girl, don't do that to yourself, you know? Like, so I need to also not do that to myself. So anyways, I'm gonna let this settle before I make a mark on it, but I will show you guys a close up. Okay, so that leaves 4 products that I'm rolling into this project pan. It's like a whole new project pan now, and I'm very excited. So let's get into those. Okay, so to start off, I have a skincare product. I have been trying to finish this skincare item off for such a long time. I don't know, I'm just hoping that by putting it into this project pan, I'll be able to get some better use out on it. But this is the Kiehl's Midnight Recovery Concentrate. And if I'm looking at it through my, like, with the light behind it, we are about right here. I do like this product, but I've had it for a really long time. I'm kind of surprised it does anything anymore. But yeah, I want to get it moved out. I have some other skincare that I definitely prefer over this, and it's obviously not cruelty free. So yeah, for that reason too, I would like to move it out of my collection. The next product I have is from Caudalie. It is their Beauty Elixir. Caudalie is not cruelty free, obviously. That's why I'm putting it in this project pan, and we are about right here. I will be marking these, by the way, but I usually use this when I'm doing like my foundation and like my cream products. I'll kind of spray this on before blending things out with a beauty blender. So that's probably how I will use this up, but I also just use this kind of throughout the day if I'm feeling like I need some hydration in my skin. I like this product, so I don't think it's going to be hard to use this up. It's kind of a bummer that the brand is not cruelty-free because I would probably... This is actually my 2nd bottle of this, so I probably would continue to repurchase it if they were, but they aren't, so I'm gonna get this moved out of my collection because it's kind of been sitting for a while. I threw it in a drawer and forgot about it, so I need to get this used up. Neither of those 2 products are in my makeup inventory because they're not makeup items, so those won't really help with my percentage, but that's another thing. I will try and calculate my percentage after this video. I'm not going to do a cruelty-free percentage this time around because I have a lot of work that needs to be done on my makeup inventory, my spreadsheet, to get that calculated. I need to add a lot of new stuff, and I need to take away the things that I've decluttered thus far and all of that. So I probably actually won't do that until I'm done decluttering, so I can kind of just take one pass through my makeup inventory. But I just wanted to let you know that those 2 products won't affect that percentage at all, but the other ones will. But not super important. Anyways, let's continue on. So I forgot about this. It was hiding back there. I also have the Kiehl's Daily Reviving Concentrate, and it is like super low. Like, it's only got a couple more uses on it. So I decided to kind of combine this with the other Kiehl's product as like one item for this project pan. I do fully expect to have this used up in the next week or so. I just like keep forgetting to use it, so I'm putting it in. Okay, sorry, my camera died. So I was talking about this guy. I just want to put this into the project pan so that I remember to finish it off because it's just been sitting there for a while and I keep forgetting to get the last final uses out of it. Next up, I have a kind of depressing product. I'm so bummed that this brand is no longer cruelty-free. The level of mad that I am about this brand not being cruelty-free is close up there with how I feel about Wet n Wild not being cruelty-free. I am putting in the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula. This is my favorite bronzer, so you know what, Physicians Formula, if you ever happen to be watching this, you just take your Butter Bronzer and stick it where the sun don't shine, okay? Very upset. This is like the only product that I even actually really like from the brand, to be completely honest. Like, I have some other ones, but they weren't like favorites. This one was like a favorite. So, very upset. Regardless though, it is what it is. So I am just going to pan or declutter the products that I have. Regardless, okay, let's move on. So I'm putting this into the project. This is my favorite bronzer, like I mentioned, and I figure I'm gonna keep this in my collection as I'm testing out other bronzers to see like what's a good dupe for it, and then I'll have it to compare to the other bronzers that I'm trying out. And while it's in my collection, I might as well pan it, and I'm not panning at this moment any other bronzers, I don't believe. So I figured, why not put this product in here? So I already have pan on this. This has been in, I believe, 2 projects already. I think, I could be wrong, but I do think that this has already been in a couple projects. So yeah, I already have pan on this, and it's a pretty substantial pan. I mean, there's still a crap load of product left in here, but at least we've got a nice pan already going. And yeah, I do want to go ahead and finish this off. I think it's definitely doable. This is also the lighter shade, it's the lightest shade that they have in this product. I do think I can build it up if I am self-tanning, and that will help me get more use out of it. So I might do that a few times just to really get a lot of use out of this. So yeah, that's my fourth product. The next product I have is actually an eyeshadow palette, and this is the only eyeshadow palette that I am keeping, I believe, that is not cruelty-free. And the reason that I'm keeping it is because it is kind of sentimental for me. I'm very attached to, so I feel like I can't declutter it, so that means I have to pan it. So it's the Lorac Little Black Palette, I believe is the name of this palette. It has been discontinued for a while. It has some baked eyeshadows in here, and they're really, really pretty. I'm gonna go ahead and swatch them for you. It's a very high quality palette, I feel like. And I don't know, I mean, it still performs well despite it being pretty old. Yeah, I have to pan this. I just have to. So those are the swatches. Obviously very, very pretty, very wearable, very everyday, I feel like. So I do think I can get a lot of good use out of this. However, I am doing a pan those shadows project, and I do have 2 other eyeshadows that I'm working on in my whole collection project pan. So I do have a lot going on in terms of eyeshadows, but I think I can make this work. My goal be to kind of set like usage goals every single, like per update, you know, so for like by the time of my next update, I want to use it X number of times, like that kind of thing, to really try and set those goals and stick to them. But yeah, I would like to completely use up all those shades. So not just hit pan on them, but actually use them all up. And I do believe that's going to take a while because they are like domed. So yeah, it's gonna be a lot. I think I'm gonna go ahead and keep it in this project the whole time. I don't think I'm going to like try and roll it out and then roll it back in and kind of take breaks from it. I think I'm just gonna keep it in this project and just kind of like monitor it throughout the rest of its lifetime. So yeah, that was the last product I had to roll in to this project. The only other thing I had to say is I think I might start updating this project pan every month just to try and stay on top of things, not check out of the project again, but we'll see. And my project pan updates might be a little funky going forward because I'm filming these in the middle of May, but by the time they get uploaded, it'll be later this week. So I think we're already into like May 20th and things like that. So it's already kind of the end of the month. And then, so I think my next project pan updates will go up at the end of June, probably not at the beginning of June, if that makes sense. I'm gonna So it'll be a little bit over a month before I have my next project panning updates, but they will be coming and I will get back on track, and I'm just kind of trying to get them back to where I was originally uploading, like the time of the month that I was originally uploading these. So I hope that that makes sense, what I just explained. I don't know if it even made sense to me. It's late, I need to stop filming. Let me know if you've panned any of these products, and yeah, other than that, I don't really have too much else. Make sure you're checking out the playlist so that you are seeing other people that are doing this product. And also don't forget to check over on Instagram for people doing the project over there. Anyways, that's it for me. I hope you all are staying safe and staying healthy, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye. And